One craft that you can do to help understand the relationship between the sun, the earth, the moon, and what exactly is happening during an eclipse is with a paper plate, some white paper or cardstock, and you get to color a little bit too. So what you're gonna need is either a paper plate or a large circle cut out of paper. You're then going to need a medium circle cut out of paper or cardstock or another paper plate. And it doesn't have to be perfect. As you can see, the circle's a little lumpy. That's perfectly fine. It's more for the concept than being exact here. And then an even smaller circle. This smaller circle is going to represent your moon. And that larger circle that we cut out is going to represent the Earth, with your plate or your biggest circle representing the sun. Now, what you need is another piece of paper or cardstock, and you're gonna go ahead and cut a couple of strips, one that's a little bit longer and one that's a little bit shorter. And again, the exact length doesn't matter, but it's important that one of them is long enough so that the Earth is gonna be farther away from the sun than the moon will be to the Earth. And I'll show you this in just a moment. And I'm actually gonna use two pieces of this taped together, because I don't think one is gonna be quite long enough for me here. So I'm gonna go ahead and make this long strip of paper by just taping these together like this. Now, before you go ahead and attach everything, this is a great activity if you like to color. You can use crayons, you can use pencils, you can use paint, and go ahead and decorate your sun however you want. You can decorate your Earth however you want, and your moon too. But you're also gonna need these little pins here, the kind that open up once you push them through. This is gonna help secure the paper parts to each other. So in the center of your sun, you're going to need to poke a hole with one of these little pins. And then you're going to attach your longer strip of paper or cardstock to this pin that you poked through your sun. And then you can fold that over to secure it. And you'll notice that this can move pretty freely. Then you're gonna wanna attach your Earth to the end of your long piece of paper, this long strip that you have coming off your sun. So you can poke a little hole in the center of your Earth. Just attach it to this end of your strip here. And what you can actually do from here is go ahead and attach your smaller strip. And that way, everything is attached in one. And you'll see why in just a second. So now you should have your plate or your largest circle attached to your longer strip, attached to your medium circle, which is your Earth, all attached to another smaller strip. And this smaller strip is going to attach to your smallest circle, which is going to represent the moon. One thing that you just want to make sure of is that the moon is connected to the Earth between the Earth and the strip coming off the sun. So that way, when the moon part is going around the Earth, it actually does come in between the Earth and the sun, like what happens during an eclipse. So what we have here is a relationship between the sun, the Earth, and the moon. The Earth revolves around the sun, but the moon also revolves around the Earth. And what happens in a total solar eclipse is the moon's path around the Earth ends up crossing between the Earth and the sun just so that the sun actually is blocked by the moon. And this creates a shadow onto the Earth, which is what we end up seeing during that total eclipse and why it gets dark. And the distance from the moon to the sun is just right so that the moon's shadow covers the entirety of what we can see of the sun here on Earth.